That's how cholesterol is quietly killing you, especially when it doesn't get the attention it deserves. Well, quite often we hear conflicting opinions online, like...
LDL has always been thought of as the bad guy. High LDL, oh, you need a statin. So dietary fat turns out to not be very important in terms of cardiovascular disease.
Proteins that we select should be lean, as in low saturated fat.
The dangerous cholesterol that is in your arteries, that is plaquing the arteries, is not coming from the dietary fat that you're consuming, okay?
So who is right? Well, when somebody dies suddenly from a heart attack, we cry, we say condolences, and forget. Well, most people do, I don't. So here is my mechanical engineering approach or new angle for you. So hopefully by the end of the video, you will be able to better understand what's going on and be able to form your own opinion. You know how fat does not dissolve in water and has a tendency to float on top. And that's the reason why your liver cannot simply dump cholesterol into the bloodstream. Cholesterol is fat, it doesn't dissolve in blood. And for that reason, we have something called lipoprotein. It's a special vehicle which carries cholesterol around, almost like an Amazon truck carries presents for Christmas in the neighborhood. And this way, it can get anywhere it needs. To your kidneys, to your lungs, to your heart. But that's where the problem starts. Because these vehicles, well, they can get into accidents. And like imagine this is your artery, a high-speed road. And by the way, that also explains why you don't get heart disease in the veins. The speed limit is there much lower. And we have these vehicles, ApoBs they're called, these lipoproteins, carrying cholesterol around. And if that would work as a German Autobahn, where everyone follows the rules and the road is absolutely pristine, life actually might be good. But unfortunately, in the real life, we have blood pressure, which can go up. We have triglycerides. We have blood sugar. We have inflammation. We have insulin. We have homocysteine. And by the way, the dead list of them all, probably we have Lp(a). So you might understand why this picture is suddenly getting a little more complicated than many people would like to tell you. So what's going on? Blood pressure. It's like a high wind. If you ever driven in the hurricane, it blows and the vehicles tend to run into the ditch and smash. And that's how you get deposits of cholesterol and might get rancid. And that's how everything starts. You have triglycerides, which are like pedestrians trying to run across the road. You have blood sugar, which is like running on studded tires. Not so good for the road. We have inflammation, which turns the throat into muck. We have insulin. That's big deal, by the way, because insulin is an opener. It's supposed to open the muscle cells, open those GLUT4 transporters. So imagine driving on the road with open manholes here and there. That's a recipe for disaster and a lot of accidents. We have homocysteine, which is a marker of methylation, because somebody in the body has to clean up all this mess. And we also have HDL to carry some cholesterol away, and we have immunity system to clean it up. And as I said, homocysteine is a marker of methylation, which does all the repairs and DNA activation to improve things. And when homocysteine is elevated, well, something is bad going on. And as I said, we also have Lp little a. Those guys are truck carrying rancid oil, oxidized LDL, and when they crash, well, they create huge chunks of spillage and toxic sludge around. Well, hopefully it makes some sense and clarifies things a little. One thing to remember, no vehicles, no accidents. And if you want, in the next video, we can take a look at this dense versus fluffy cholesterol.
Small dense, on the other hand, is very important.
And we can look in the statins as well, when they make sense or when they don't. Meanwhile, living is smart, aging is bad. Go check the video about methylation and repair works. See ya.